Love is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to arise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Disturb you or something?
No, I need to talk to you. As you know, I'm new in this place. So if I wanted to talk to someone, I'm sure nobody would listen. You're just in time. Someone can treat me to coffee now and listen to me talk about philosophy.
Don't worry, I'm really gonna listen to you.
I never really thought that I'd learn philosophy. I never had it in mind. My philosophy professor, Professor Keen, he knows a lot about Chinese philosophy. He recommended many books on philosophy to me that talked about Chinese philosophers. I didn't know our philosophers were really great men.
Bruce, now that you are really into philosophy, are you leaving Kung Fu now?
This sounds ironic, but actually Chinese martial arts theories are also included in philosophy. For example, the yin-yang doctrine. The entire universe is made up of the yin and yang interaction. And from that, our philosophers conceived the theory of Taoism. Till now, I still remember that time when I first learned Yung Chun Chuan. Master asked me, Bruce, have you read the Book of Taoism? I said yes, but I didn't really get it. Now I realize that if I could understand Taoism through Lao Tzu's book and its teachings, then I'm pretty sure I'll be able to improve my skills in Kung Fu. Do you know what I learned from those Chinese philosophical classics that I read? It's very essential. I found that the foundation of our Kung Fu is philosophy. Actually, the philosophy behind Yin and Yang is not related just to martial arts and their theories, but to actual boxing matches as well. That's how big Yin Yang's influence is to us. Come on, I'll show you how that is.
Sure.
It's really easy. Kimura.
Yeah?
Make sure you're ready for attacking. In this position, we're fighting as opponents. Are you following me so far? Mm-hmm. Be sure, okay? You see that? Every time we attack and we defend, we do with the interchange of Yin and Yang. Moreover, boxing is an exercise that builds your body. Skill is a way to learn from others to be able to win. Now the real question is, where do we get our skills?
I don't know.
It's like this. It actually lies on the interchange of yin and yang. Listen, okay? When you attack an enemy, you also leave yourself very open. When you defend is, in fact, the best time for you to make an attack. Understand?
Yes.
It's like this. Whenever you make a move to attack, punch me. You see that? You actually leave me room to make an attack.
Can you show me?
Listen. It is said, upon attaining the pinnacle of one's power and greatness, will follow a fall. That's what I want to tell you. Make sure you know it by heart. If you want to improve your Kung Fu and further increase your skills, then you have to always follow the regular pattern of yin and yang. Keep this in mind. The theoretical base of Kung Fu is philosophy. Got that? I actually believe that for someone to become a great master, he has to understand philosophy as well as learn yin and yang. And Taoism.
Taoism?
How was it? Today's lesson was really important. Did you learn a lot?
Yeah, I did. I'm sure that there are many great martial artists, but I think there's only one that can link martial arts to philosophy. That person is you. You know, Bruce, I'm certain you'll become a martial arts legend. That's why right now I feel lucky to be your student.
I wish you're right.
By the way, Bruce, have you thought about starting a kung fu school?
Kung fu school, you say?
Yeah, we talked about this before, just a few days back. You said that you wanted kung fu to be the number one martial arts known all over the world, and establishing a kung fu house will be the right way to achieve that. Before, when Japanese judo and karate were introduced to the US, nobody knew about them. But the Japanese are good. I mean, we made them known by starting martial arts dojos. Through that, Japanese martial arts became known across the country. That's how things happen for us. That's why I'm thinking, since you have that kind of goal, maybe you can do what the Japanese did back then. Use us as an example.
You're right. In doing that, I'll be able to make Chinese kung fu popular in America. But you know, the thing is, I'm not yet ready. I don't know what to do.
What do you mean by that? I don't get it.
Renting houses, equipment, all of that. Those are problems. Look at me now. I don't have a job. I'm really obviously broke. And I can't do anything.
You're saying that getting enough funds is your main concern. Maybe I can sell my tea house for you. That should make some money.
What's that? Are you nuts?
No, I'm not crazy. If I asked you, you wouldn't agree that I sell the tea house for your kung fu house, so I decided to sell it myself.
But why? Kimura, you know what? I've actually learned about your past. I know that you've devoted yourself so much to that one place you own. I know that tea house means everything to you. It's your life.
That's fine, Bruce. I got a different life. Now it's kung fu. Compared to that big dream you have, my small tea house means little. It's really nothing. You understand? You know, Bruce, from the day you agreed to take me as your student, I was able to find a whole new purpose, and that's to spend all my life to support you, to learn Chinese kung fu. And now, the kung fu I have is not only a way of fighting people, it's not only for my own interest. It's become a way to train my spirit and the meaning of my life, my purpose. That's why, for the sake of kung fu, I'm willing to give up everything. Just tell me, Bruce, whenever you feel you're decided, I'll sell my tea house. I'll do it.
No. Wait, Kimura. I know that what you said just now is all very sincere, but I will never spend the money from the sale of your tea house just for my kung fu house. Come on. That will make me uneasy all my life.
Really? It's okay, Bruce.
That's enough. Let's make a deal. You're not going to mention that to me again. Understand? Let's go. Professor, have you read my paper yet?
Oh, yes, I have. You wrote that paper on ancient Chinese philosophy, right? I actually read it quite a number of times. You know what, Bruce Lee? I find your paper really good.
Professor Qin, I didn't expect that you'd give me an A+.
The important thing is I found that your understanding of philosophy is very much beyond your age. That really impressed me. I've been teaching for quite a number of years, and you're the first student I've met with such a profound understanding of Chinese philosophy. It's quite innovative for you to interpret Chinese kung fu using philosophy. Also, your narrative is very deep and comprehensive.
But Professor Qin, you praise me too much.
No, I don't think so, Bruce. I don't like the Chinese style of humility. I praised you because you were good. I didn't overpraise you at all. It would be hypocritical if I did that. Remember, Bruce, whether it's overpraising or over-humility, it doesn't matter, because they're all false anyway. Philosophy is above all hypocrisy.
Okay, I got it. I gotta go.
Hold on. What do you do in your spare time?
Basically, reading and practicing kung fu. I also have spare time to do some part-time jobs to make a living.
Do you still feel confused about anything?
A little bit.
What do you mean by a little bit?
Mostly because I can't find a comparable rival.
A comparable rival? I don't understand what you mean.
Professor Qin, when I first met you, I told you about my goal. I want to be a great martial arts master. I want to be the best that I can become. But after I came to Seattle and visited different martial arts houses and had a match with a Japanese karate artist, the result was even the so-called best karate master in Seattle couldn't even take just a single punch from me.
So you want to find someone who can help you improve your kung fu skills?
That's right.
And you're saying that Seattle has disappointed you, right?
I guess so.
Ah, now I understand. Have you heard of the saying by Rodin? It goes like this. Here there is no lack of beauty in the world. But notice, that's it. Let's paraphrase to understand it better. Here there is no lack of martial arts masters in the world. But notice, there is a similar saying in Chinese philosophy. If you cannot find a rival at present, you just have to compete with yourself for now.
I need to compete with myself?
That's right. A person's greatest enemy is none other but himself. Your major is the best way for you to learn that. In addition, I see martial arts not just a means to build up your body or to compete, but the biggest learning in martial arts is probably the embodiment of a certain culture. Now that's more important than finding another person to fight or to compete against. You know, Bruce, now that you can't seem to find any rival at college or in Seattle, then you'd better take this time to meditate. Think of how you can create your own theories for your own martial arts.
So you mean you want me to make my own martial arts theory?
Exactly. I don't want to sound like I'm preaching to you, Bruce Lee, but I want you to do something that's not difficult for you.
And what's that?
Recently, Chinese classical philosophy has been the rage for American students to take as an elective course. They need more teachers. Perhaps you can start giving lectures.
I can't do that, Professor. I don't think I'm up for that right now. Maybe I can just teach them Kung Fu instead.
Oh, that false modesty again. You know what? The paper you submitted was excellent. It was great. You know, Bruce, I really believe in you. And this isn't an overcompliment.
Professor, I can't.
Oh, I think you can.
I still feel that I'm not really...
Oh, now I get it. Chinese culture is some kind of inexplicable obscurity that is veiled in mystery. Usually Chinese scholars are unwilling to share their knowledge to others. They like to keep to themselves. American culture, on the other hand, calls for individuality.
Professor...
We never cover up our advantages and strengths. For instance, I think it's good for you to show off your Kung Fu skills. It's the best way to adopt American culture.
Professor, I still feel a little bit...
All right, Bruce Lee. Trust your own understanding of martial arts philosophy.
I understand.
And trust yourself. I believe you'll give the students an interesting lecture. But do not forget, give examples of your Kung Fu to the listeners so that they'll be impressed. Just a little bit, though. That'll make your lecture quite lively. I know you'll do very well. Just believe in yourself.
Professor, I think I got your point now. All right, then. I'll try as you said. I'll do it.
I'm sure you'll do great with that lecture.
Okay, listen to me, please. This is the symbol of yin and yang. It may look very simple, but it has a lot of philosophy in it.
What's that?
Why are you laughing? The symbol was created by my Chinese ancestors over 3,000 years ago. This is yang. Yang represents firmness, movement, masculinity, reality, light, morning, heat energy. Yin here is its direct opposite. It represents stillness, weakness, darkness, frailty, coldness, femininity, and so on. Actually, in Tai Chi, the theoretical basis is nothing is permanent, except for change, of course. When something goes up, it'll eventually reach its peak. After that, it will start to decline, right here. This is yin. Now, when the decline reaches the end, when it's all over, it'll start flourishing again. That flourishing is yang. The whole process is an interchange of rising and falling. Therefore, we can see the different forces. In conclusion, on the surface, they're both opposing, but interdependent. That's one way to see it. But if this time we use a new viewpoint, then you'll see that these two forces inside are actually united.
Can you give an example?
Okay. I will use Kung Fu as an example to explain what I'm saying. Does anybody here know the actual meaning or essence of martial arts?
What else, man? I think the only essence of martial arts is fighting, nothing else.
Yeah, that's right. They just want to hurt people.
Yes, miss?
Since martial arts is fighting, then it's the confrontation of yin and yang.
From what Linda said, martial arts is what men and women often do when they're together at night.
Okay. we'll have time for that. Let's move on with the theory of yin and yang, all right? I will use kung fu fighting as an example. Actually, what Linda said is correct. She understood what I was saying. Fighting is where yin and yang interact. When your opponent hits you, whenever you're attacked, that's called yang, while defense is yin. How do yin and yang exchange? That happens when you change yin into yang. That's possible. When your opponent makes an attack, you change the power he has and use it against him. That method is the best kept secret of a master.
Can you give us a demonstration if it's all right?
Sure, I guess. To make it more visual, I'll need someone to help me so I can demonstrate this to everyone. Is there anyone who's willing to help me out?
I'll help you, man.
All right!
Go Bush! Go Bush! Go Bush! Go Bush! Go Bush! Yeah, go Bush!
I'm warning you in front of everyone. I can give you a bloody nose.
My nose is strong. I don't think I'll get hurt that much.
You sure you won't hurt your nose?
Go ahead. Come on. You know, if you were actually in a fight right now, it's your nose that would bleed. Okay, do it again.
Come on.
Hit me. Come on.
Yeah! That's great!
Okay, go back to your seat. Good job. As you saw, what I did was I used his own attack through his own power, then took advantage of the moment where he was to counterattack. This is a simple process of the conversion of yin into yang. So, tell me, anyone else?
Me, I want to try it.
I want to try it.
Yeah.
I got
yeah.
to try, man.
Yeah.
Come on, let's go up there.
Right, so what are you going to do?
Yeah. Try to kick me, all right?
All right, I'll kick
Use your
you.
Left foot.
Okay.
Attack. Good.
Wow. Okay.
Not bad. Again. All right. Faster. That's it. One more time. Good. You're getting the hang of it.
Persuade your master. Please tell him to help us out.
Kimura. Kimura is the biggest coward I know.
That Kimura. He was useless from the very beginning.
All right. Go and buy that tea house he's selling as soon as you can. I will convince Master Yamamoto to give lessons about humility and respect to that arrogant Chinese.
Before?
Yeah. Every time Dad comes to America, he makes sure he comes here. That's why I come here often. But I guess I haven't taken a man over to this place to have dinner with me. You're the first guy that I asked to come with me to dine here. Is everything okay?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Then why are you just standing there?
You're kind of cute when you laugh.
Really now? I didn't think you had it in you to give out compliments. I thought you didn't know how to praise people at all.
Really?
Bruce, actually, I wanted to talk to you about the two of us.
What about it?
I wanna give you a little surprise.
What surprise is that?
Dad told me that he'll make a special visit, so he's arriving anytime.
A special visit, you say?
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean by that?
How can I say this? He wants to see my man. whatever you ask him. I'm sure he's gonna give it to you.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna die now.
Come on, love. Can you just die later after we've had dinner? Huh?
Mr. Kimura, your tea house is doing really good right now. Why do you want to sell it at this time?
Oh, it's embarrassing. Something happened to my family. An emergency.
All right. If you could lower the price, maybe by 10%, I'll buy it right away.
Okay.
Count it. This money is all yours now. And this tea house is now mine, okay?
I want to buy everyone a drink. Let's drink before I leave.
What's that again? After all that you've done, you still have the nerve?
Don't bother. You don't have to stay here. Just go away.
Kimura, listen to me. You're not allowed to come to this place anymore. Something happened to your family. An emergency? You were lying all along. You can't fool me. You followed the Chinese master to learn his so-called kung fu. You even sold this place to help him have a kung fu house. Kimura, I'm right, aren't I? Hmm? From this day forward, your countrymen will condemn you and your treachery. You should be ashamed. Don't you even consider yourself Japanese ever again. You're nothing but scum.
What? We're done with the deal, right? Why do you still talk to me this way? Don't you break that thing.
We're not even interested in this place at all. All we want is to get back the dignity you threw away. This place, from now on, will become a real Japanese martial arts house. Leave us, Kimura.
Please, Yu-Tian. I really hope that you won't think of me that narrowly.
Beginning this day, my friend and I will start managing this place. Do you want to leave by yourself? Or would you rather we drag you out?
Just get out. Although you sold your tea house at a very reasonable price, I'm still disappointed. Because a coward is in front of me. Get out. Don't forget to take your garbage with you. I don't want them. Take those things that you own out of this place.
Don't worry. Just ask someone to pick them up.
Kimura, one more thing. Master Yamamoto has already come to Seattle, and we will get our revenge and beat that Bruce Lee! You shameless coward! Go and tell your Chinese master to prepare for his defeat! What is it?
I'm looking for Kimura. He's the boss of this place.
Are you blind? He's no longer the boss of this place.
That's impossible. What happened?
Use your eyes and don't just ask. This is Yamamoto's karate dojo. Come on, get out of here.
Wait, Yu-Tian. This man came here to help me. He's the one who will take my belongings from me.
Whoa. Mr. Kimura, you sold this place?
Isn't that obvious? That's why I packed all my stuff.
But why'd you do that? You haven't moved out yet, and they've already changed the sign? Why?
I can't answer that. Come on, Jesse. Just help me with my things. Let's do this fast.
Where are you going now?
I don't know. Let's go, Jesse.
Whoa.
with the Iron Man here. I'll be right back, sir.
But, come on, let's put him down here.
Here we go.
Okay. Wait.
Okay, come on.
You okay, Kimura? Anything wrong?
I'm okay. Let's go on with the lesson.
Again. Your Qin Suan emphasizes one point. You always have to remember this. The best defense you have is your offense. Defend. Use your fists and feet to attack. You have to be very quick.
Okay.
You have to be very accurate. Speed is the key, all right? Push your speed to the limit. You got that? Good. Earlier, what you saw was the eliminating attack. You strike to eliminate. Remember this. Always think of water. Water can easily adapt. It has no form. That's why it's a substance that takes anything shape. It's the softest substance that exists in our planet. But it can destroy. Okay? Let's go. All together. One. Two. What's the problem? I can tell there's something wrong.
You're right. You know what? You shouldn't be wasting so much time with them. Don't teach your students Kung Fu for free.
So you mean I should charge a fee for what I teach them?
Not really. Anyway, I want to tell you something. The guy named Yamamoto, a sixth dan holder, arrived in Seattle.
Really? Why'd you tell me only now? You know where he is? We gotta see that man. You know what? In Seattle, after I defeated you, I've never found any opponent. I can hardly wait right now. He came just in time. Please, man, go ask him. Tell him I want to have a fight with him. I want to know if he's good. You know me, without practice, I'll get rusty, and we don't want that. Go, set a match with him.
You take things like they're not important. When I used to run the tea house before, these Japanese masters would somewhat respect me. But since I became your apprentice, they haven't been so easy on me.
Then I'll beat that guy. Wherever that master's from, whether he comes from the east or even from the west, he will give you respect once I defeat him. And maybe he can become my apprentice.
Bruce, after I left them, Yu Tian invited Master Yamamoto to come. The master came straight from Japan to Seattle. His only aim is to beat you. He wants to take you down.
If he can do that, I'm really eager to fight now. I'll see if he can actually take me down.
If that's the case, stop delivering newspapers then. Just prepare yourself. Here.
I don't need your money. Keep that, all right? I told you before, I don't want nor need help from people. Not even my own parents. I can take care of myself.
I just want to help you for now. You'll earn your money later.
How's that?
A kung fu house. You can build one.
Stop talking about that nonsense, will you? That's not the issue, okay? The issue now is for you to find Yamamoto for me. I want to fight him.
I bet he'll come to you pretty soon.
I hope you're right.
Bruce, just relax. Have a seat right there. I'll be back. Just wait here. Bruce, I hate you. You haven't told me where you are. It's been so long now. Did you drop into the Pacific? Did you fight someone again? Did you get badly hurt? Bruce, I've already graduated. I really miss you so much. I know Ma and Pa, They don't want me to go out with a man as aggressive as you are. Still, I asked your mother to give me your address so I can write to you. I'll marry you, Bruce. Just come back to me. We can enter show business, we'll have movies, we'll earn a lot, we'll be really, really happy. I just don't want you to practice martial arts. I don't like to see you fighting every single day of your life. Bruce, please come back. Bruce, you know what? Every day, I wait for you to come back. I hope that you can come home very soon. It's so sad to be alone. Please don't leave me by myself.
Hey, wait for me!
I sometimes feel like I still can't control my strength.
The thing is, maybe you're not in the right position. Work that out.
Bruce!
Huh?
See you, man.
Let's go! Come on now!
Where do you want to take me now?
Just come with me. I want you to meet someone.
And who's that?
My dad.
Your father?
That's right. I've already told you about this. Dad came to America yesterday. He wants to get to know you. Let's go!
I'm just so nervous. I don't know what to say. How will your father react?
Just tell him that you love me and will marry me.
I can't do that. We haven't talked about it. I don't have anything now. I mean, I don't have money.
If you want to marry me, we'll take care of it. You don't have to worry.
Why is that?
Actually, to tell you the truth, my dad's well known, because he's a former minister. That's why we have a wealthy family.
Can you say that again? Your father used to be a minister?
Mm-hmm. Surprised?
Surprised? No.
Why is that? I thought you'd prefer that my dad was a common man.
Whether your father is just common, or maybe a minister, it's got nothing to do with me.
Why are you saying that? Hey, he's gonna be our father-in-law. He says we can get married if we like.
What? Your father's allowing me to marry you? Then he'll buy me a house and a car, right?
Yeah. Although, it wouldn't be here. It would be in the Philippines.
The Philippines?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not getting this.
Okay, I'll tell you now. My dad has already agreed that we quit school and go to the Philippines. After that, he'll help you get a Filipino citizenship so you can live there. And you know what? We have a villa beside the ocean that's huge. We don't have to do anything there. We can just live a happy life. Besides, if you want to continue your studies, whether it's in the Philippines or in the UK, it's okay.
I don't want to leave the US.
Hey, come on, Bruce. You're a guy majoring in philosophy, but so what? We're living in a realistic world. I don't believe you'll have good chances here. I don't think studying philosophy in America will get you anywhere.
I'll develop my kung fu and have a career here in America. I'll work hard so I can make Chinese kung fu number one all over the world.
Can't you see? That's useless now. There are modern weapons now if you haven't noticed that yet. I don't know if your martial arts will have a future anywhere.
I want to become not just a great master of kung fu. I have a dream bigger than that. I want to be a kung fu philosopher. That's my goal in life.
Fine. Let's count that as one of your goals in life, hmm? But so what? Can you even live on that? Can that fill your stomach? You know what I think? I don't want to live a life like this with you.
Fine, Alona. Tell me, you love me, right?
Of course.
You like kung fu or not?
Not so much.
I understand now. We got to know each other only because of kung fu. It was also kung fu that bonded us. You could make your father accept me or not. You could buy me a house or a car and give me a happy life. But you can't accept my kung fu. And that saddens me a lot.
Just because I don't like kung fu, am I right? Am I right? Don't you know how to answer me?
Listen to me, okay? I have a girlfriend back in Hong Kong. Days ago, she wrote me a letter asking me to go home. She wants me to go back. She wants us to get married. However, I refused. You know why I did that? It's because she didn't get me. She doesn't like kung fu. She regards my passion as something that's nonsensical. She thinks that my kung fu is nothing but trouble. She even wants me to stop practicing kung fu. She said it's useless.
Can't you see that?
I was hoping you would understand. I guess this relationship's heading nowhere.
Say that again.
Alana, listen to me. I have plans and I'll make them happen. If you can't change your mind, that's okay. I just leave then.
Bruce, do you know how much pain you're causing me?
Tell me, do you know what you've done to me? You clipped my wings. For a man, there's one thing that can't be compromised. You know what that thing is, huh? It's dignity.
You think there's dignity in the life you're living now?
This is just temporary. I'll strive to have a better life. For the sake of all my goals, I'll do anything. Even sleep in the streets.
Bruce, you'll regret having those crazy ideas later.
Say what you want, but I'm not listening.
Bruce, I know you'll regret this.
I don't think so. Hi. Oh, sorry. Did I bother you?
Oh no, I found the picture I saw just now. It's so beautiful.
What picture?
An Asian dancer standing in front of the blue sea. He explains some sort of mystery by his beautiful movements.
Nice. You're so full of imagination. Correct me if I'm wrong, but you're majoring in literature, right?
No, I don't think it's only literature majors who have creativity. Can I ask you something?
Of course.
What were you doing there earlier? Was it some kind of masculine dance you were practicing?
Oh, you thought I was dancing? That's a really funny idea.
Was my question funny?
Actually, I thought it was philosophic. It made me think really hard. Dancing is an art. And Kung Fu is a martial art. I guess Kung Fu is a special art for the Chinese. It's also a dance. It's one that has the longest history connected to it. That's why I think it's the same.
That's really amazing, but I can't say the same for your memory.
Memory?
Oh, don't you remember me?
I don't understand.
My name's Linda Emery.
Linda Emery? Oh, we've met before.
Yes, the lecture. It was on Yin and Yang. Don't you remember that anymore, huh? Then it's the confrontation of Yin and Yang. Can you give us a demonstration if it's all right?
Oh, you're Linda.
Yes.
Sorry about that.
No, it's okay. I'm also a student here. Freshman at the Medical School of Washington State University. I'm kind of new here.
So you're saying we go to the same school?
That's right.
Oh, I'm very sorry. I really forgot. I didn't recognize you at first.
That's fine with me. It means I'm not beautiful.
No. You're very pretty.
Thanks. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
One, two, three!
One, two, three!
Do it again! One, two, three!
You know, I want to learn boxing with him. Do you think I'll do well?
Sure.
One, two, three! One, two!
Hi, philosopher.
Hey, what's up, Linda?
How come there are only boys in your kung fu team?
Well, I don't know. It's such a pity it's only men who have an interest in this kind of dance.
Is it okay if I ask you to count me in?
Sure, but I bet you won't last 3 days.
Let's see.
All right, you're in. Everyone, please turn around.
Come on, let's join. Hi there.
Bend your knees.
No, that's not possible. This is the lowest rate around. You can look around Seattle, but you won't find anything better. There's no other place that's nice like this and very cheap. If you don't rent it now, someone else will take it. You won't have anything then. Just take a closer look. It's really very nice.
Ooh.
I think this basement of yours hasn't been used for a long time now.
Well, I didn't clean it up.
In Seattle, I can find at least 100 basements like this.
Who are you?
Who am I? I'm the Little Map Jesse, real Seattle native. Hey boss, if you want to rent out this basement, you gotta lower the rate a bit. It's way too high. You should bring it down by 20%.
At most 10%.
Ah, no. 15%.
Oh, I can't. That's just too much.
Kimura, let's go.
Okay. It's a deal.
A deal?
That's right.
It's deal, deal then.
One, two, one, two, three. One, two, one, two, three.
Now remember, you practice kung fu not just to break a board or a layer of bricks. It's not even to fight or to show off. What should matter is its influence on us, on our lifestyles.
Philosopher. Are you talking about philosophy or about kung fu now?
I said in my lecture that kung fu includes philosophy.
It seems that the practice of Chinese kung fu also includes the mind.
If you practice that way constantly, you'll understand the one true meaning of kung fu. Okay, take a break. Now is the right time for us to take care of our hungry stomachs.
Yeah! All right! Yeah!
Yes! I'm starving.
I'm tired.
I'm